Hey guys, Gizmodict here, and first of all, thank you for the great support on my Poco X2 review that I published yesterday. A lot of you guys watched it, liked it, interacted with me in the comments. It really felt good. Thanks a lot for your support. And in that video, one comment that I got multiple times was that, where is my Poco X2 detailed PUBG review? So this is one of the most detailed PUBG reviews of the Poco X2 that you'll find on YouTube. We're gonna check out everything in this video. We'll see the FPS, we'll use GFX tool, we'll see the battery drain, the temperature check, everything will be covered in this video. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. But if you're watching my channel for the first time, you know what to do. Press the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Now, let me get started with this PUBG review. So the Poco X2, as you all know, comes with the Snapdragon 730G, and because of that, you can only go up to the ultra frame rate in PUBG by default. And ultra is 40 FPS, so a lot of you gamers were disappointed because the Poco F1 supports Smooth Plus Extreme, which is 60 FPS. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a GFX tool that will unlock the 60 FPS option on the Poco X2. And you'll ask me, why do you need to do that? Well, the thing is, I'm showing you the gameplay with 40 FPS on the default settings on the left hand side here, and you have the gameplay at 60 FPS with the GFX tool on the right hand side here. And you can see there is so much difference in the smoothness. So definitely you should enable 60 FPS because this phone can actually handle frame rates upwards of 40 FPS. And even the Redmi Note 8 Pro, which is cheaper than this phone, although performs similarly, but it gets the option of the extreme frame rate by default. So I'm gonna tell you later on how to set up the GFX tool and all of that. First of all, we're gonna see the gameplay at different settings. So let's start with Smooth Plus Extreme settings now, and as you can see, the phone can handle the game very well. So the footage that you're seeing right now, some of it has been done with the screen recording on the phone, and some of it I have recorded while playing the game, and at that time the screen recording was not on. So every time you see the footage from my camera where I am playing the game, the screen recording is off, so don't worry about that. So coming to the gameplay, as you can see here, the phone has no problems in maintaining the frame rate above 50 FPS. As you can see, majority of the times the frame rate is around 55, and sometimes it even touches 60s, so I've got no complaints with the frame rate of this phone. It's only when you do a hot drop, or when you're driving a car, or when you're in an area where there are 3-4 squads apart from your squad, you will start to see a little bit of frame drops. You will see some of these instances in the hot drops where the frame rate has gone down to the 40s. This happens very frequently if you land in a very crowded area like military base or Georgiopol crates or Novo or even Pochinki. So you have to keep that in mind that every time you do a hot drop, there is a chance the frame rate will go to the 40s. In only some rare cases, let's say in like one game out of like 6-7 games, the frame rate went below 40, but that was only for a couple of seconds. Then it did come above 250 or something like that. So overall, the frame rate stays around 45 to 55 if you ask me for an average, and that is exactly how the Realme X2 performed as well. So do check out the gameplay for yourself so that you will have a better idea how the frame rates are when you use GFX tool and you do hot drops.
Let's go! इधर ही पे।
वो साइड से है, वो साइड से है, मेन गेट से आ रहे हो, अंदर
नहीं, आया इधर,
अंदर
दो तीन जन है, स्विमिंग पूल गए
नहीं, इधर ही है।
गए गए।
मैं 7-6-2 ढूंढ रहा हूँ भाई।
पुश
हो 3-4 लोग है भाई।
किधर है बंदा?
दो बिल्डिंग में, दो बिल्डिंग में
जोन स्टार्ट हो गया भाई। देखो चल, एक भी गोली नहीं लगा इसका। हाँ रुक जा रुक जा, रुकते हैं इनके लिए। हाँ रुक जा रुक जा, थोड़ा और ऊपर ले, थोड़ा और ऊपर चलेगा। चल पत्थर है, पत्थर है, चलेगा।
आ गया,
मुख में रैंडम फायर कर, दूसरे को भी पड़ी है।
वो अंदर भागा, पेड़ पे गया। ये पत्थर पे बहुत पड़ी, उसको एक एक शॉट से बच गया। After that, I'll be shifting to HD plus extreme settings because you can do that with GFX tool as well. And even here, the gameplay is very similar to smooth plus extreme settings. It can hit 60 FPS sometimes, it is above 50 majority of the times. But it's only when you do the hot drops you see the frame drops, and actually the frame rate fluctuation is more here in comparison to the smooth settings. It's typical of what we expected. HD plus extreme is quite taxing on the phone, and even then the Poco X2 is still maintaining pretty respectable frame rates. So do check out some of the gameplay on the HD plus extreme settings. So as you saw, the Poco X2 has no problems in maintaining frame rates above 45 or 50 FPS majority of the time while playing PUBG. So I don't know why is Snapdragon 730G capped at ultra settings, because it can easily handle extreme. I think the performance is very, very similar to the Redmi Note 8 Pro, but on that phone, extreme option is available by default, which is a huge plus. So I think if somehow the Poco team can work with PUBG or Qualcomm and enable the extreme frame rate option with an update, that would be great. But anyways, apart from the frame rates, if I talk about the temperatures in the battery drain, the maximum temperature that I saw was around 43 degrees, which I think is pretty good. So the thing is, when I tested this on the Realme X2 went up to 46 degrees, but you have to understand that when I tested that phone, the climate was quite hot, we had summers, and right now we have winter, so the ambient temperature is already quite low. So even after that, this phone went to 43 degrees, which I think is pretty cool, because when you use GFX tool, you are pushing the phone above its limits. So with GFX tool, 43 degrees is a very good temperature. And even if I talk about the battery drain, when I started playing the game, I was at 96%. And after playing the game, I was down to like 71 or 72% after 1 hour and 15 minutes. So that once again is pretty solid for this phone. So no issues with battery drain and no issues with temperature either. If I compare it to the Realme X2, honestly, I don't see any major difference in the PUBG gameplay of both of these phones. Both of them perform identical with GFX tool because they have the same chipsets. The only difference that I saw was that the image quality was better on the Realme X2 because of the AMOLED display. But then the sound quality via the headphone jack was better on the Poco X2. The Poco X2 had louder and more clear audio in comparison to the Realme X2. So that is something I liked on this phone. But more or less in terms of frame rate, temperatures, battery drain, things are pretty similar, and I don't think one phone is better than the other one. Although if I compare it to the Poco F1, Poco F1 still definitely gives you better frame rates in comparison to phones with Snapdragon 730G. So the thing is, Poco F1 barely goes below 50 FPS. Majority of the times, even if you do a hot drop, the frame rate is around 55 or it's at least above 50. But the thing is that with the recent update, I think a lot of people with Poco F1 are saying that the frame drops have increased. 2-3 of my friends were complaining about it, but my experience has been pretty good on the Poco F1 when I tested it the last time. So do let me know your feedback. Has the frame rate gone down on the Poco F1 or not? And actually, Poco F1 and Zenfone 5Z are two phones which still will give you better performance in PUBG in comparison to these phones. Those phones have Smooth Plus Extreme by default, and you don't have to use any GFX tool. Talking about GFX tool, let's talk about the one that I've been using. So I have been using this for 2 to 3 months now, and if you use the GFX tool that I have linked in the description box, you will not get banned. I haven't gotten banned since like the last 3-4 months, so I don't think there will be any problems. A lot of people are using this and they haven't complained about anything. So the APK is available either on XDA Labs, or you can also get it from the Google Play Store. I think it's paid on the Google Play Store, but it's not that expensive, so you can do either of those. Once you download the APK and install it on your phone, you need to select a couple of settings. So your game version will be global. You will have to enable Smooth Plus Ultra settings, anti-aliasing, and all of those shadows should be off. And you also have to select the resolution as 1280 by 720. Don't worry, I use this setting on every phone. PUBG by default renders at a resolution of 1280 by 720. So don't think that we are playing at a lower resolution. After you have done all of that, click on apply and PUBG will start, and you will see that you have the option of Smooth Plus Extreme settings, which is great. Now you have unlocked the frame rates up to 60 FPS and you can have a much smoother PUBG experience. So basically that's your PUBG review on the Poco X2. I've tried to cover everything, but in case I've missed out anything, please ask me in the comments and I'll reply to you. Or you can even ask me your questions on my Facebook, Twitter and Instagram pages. I think the Poco X2 performed as I expected it to be. For less than 20,000 rupees, this is one of the phones that has very good PUBG performance apart from the Realme X2 and the Redmi K30. But still, the Poco F1 and the Zenfone 5Z are the winners in this price bracket. But this is not a bad phone considering that you are willing to use GFX tool. I will be coming with a lot of camera comparisons very soon, so if you don't want to miss those videos out, please subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, please like it, share it with your friends, and I will be back in a notifications very, very soon. Peace.